Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing very well and you are preparing with the given videos and the PDF files on the WhatsApp group. So my dear students, today once again I am here with the fifth lecture of the class 11th biology and the chapter same which we have started in the last many videos, that is the diversity in the living world. Same chapter we are discussing in the small portions topic wise. So today we will start our next topic, that is the binomial nomenclature or scientific name. What was the last topic in the last video? The last topic was nomenclature. The last topic was nomenclature. Right? Last topic was the nomenclature of living organism. Nomenclature of living organism we have discussed. Nomenclature means how we have to give the names to the different organism. Right? So, on the basis of that, we have discussed in the last video that nomenclatures are names of the living organisms are of two types. The first one is the common or vernacular names and second one is the scientific or biological names. You can say also scientific or biological names. So, today we will study the scientific names. First of all, I would like to tell you that what is the benefit, what is the advantage of the scientific name or biological name. The very precious advantage is that, the very most important advantage is that the binomial or scientific names or biological names are universally accepted. It will not change according to area or country to country or language to language. It will not change. It will remain same for one particular kind of the living organism everywhere on the earth. Everywhere it will be universally accepted. So what is the second benefit? Second benefit is that by using the binomial nomenclature or the scientific names, the ambiguity of the names. Ambiguity means the different names for one kind of the different names for one organism or multiplicity of the names for one thing, there are the many vernacular names, right? So multiplicity of the names, ambiguity of the names is totally finished by using the scientific names, and these are the universally accepted. So let's come on the topic. The binomial nomenclature, or you can say the scientific name, is given by Carolus Linnaeus in 1753. He was the biologist, or you can say he was the taxonomist. He was the taxonomist, or he was the scientist, biologist related with the study of the organism, plants and animals. So first of all, he has started the idea of the scientific name, so that by utilizing these scientific names, we can avoid the multiplicity of the names of one kind of the organism. This idea binomial nomenclature is given by the scientific names, that is the biological nomenclature. Now, father of taxonomy, Carolus Linnaeus, sometime you will get also the name Carl von Linnaeus. Carolus Linnaeus is also called the father of taxonomy because he has started the idea of taxonomy or classification or nomenclature. Now, when he started his famous book Systema Naturae or Systema Nature in 1758, he has given this idea of the taxonomy or classification in his famous book, that is the System Nature. And in this book, he has given the correct scientific name of the different organisms. For example, first of all, I would like to tell you binomial nomenclature. Why it is called the binomial nomenclature? Bi means two. Nominal means names. Nomenclature to provide the name. So, according to the taxonomical sentence means Carolus Linnaeus, scientific name of every living organism is consist of the two names. Is consist of two names. For example, human, Homo sapiens. This is the, we have discussed in the last video. For example, earthworm. The scientific name, Ferretima posthuma. This is the scientific name of earthworm. For example, tapeworm. That is Tinea solium. For example, in plants, onion. Its name is Allium sepa. Right? For example, you can also write the more examples. I can give you rose plant. The rose plant which we are developing in our garden, Rosa indica. For example, China rose. In Hindi, it is called Gulal ka phool. China rose, hibiscus, Rosa sinensis. Many examples I can give you. I am having the names of the different animals and plants. Like for example, in the last video, I have given the few examples like wheat plant, Triticum aestivum. Like rice plant, Oryza sativa. And for example, prawn, that is called Paleomon. For example, Labio rohita. For example, if one kind of the fish we are using as a food, that is called the Rohu machli. So Rohu, its name is Labio rohita. So why I am giving you different examples? Because you can see here, these are the common names and these are the scientific names. Is it clear? So you can look here that the common names are changeable, means they will vary according to the language to language or country to country, but these scientific names are fixed for everywhere. It is universally accepted. But you can see, look here, that every scientific name has two parts. Homo sapiens, two parts. This one is first part, this one is second part. So binomial nomenclature has the first part name is called genus and second part name is called species name. Second part is called the species name. First part of the binomial nomenclature is called generic name or genus name, and second part is called the specific or species name. And due to the having two parts in one name, this classification is considered as binomial nomenclature. Bi means two, nomial means two, nomial means name. So due to the presence of the two parts in the names, this is considered as binomial nomenclature given by the Carolus Linnaeus. I hope this is clear to you. Now come on the next topic. If in anywhere, for example, you have written mango, its name is Mangifera indica, then in the last Linnaeus, we have to add the scientist name who has given द साइंटिफिक नेम ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर मैंगो का नेम मैंगीफेरा इंडिका लीनियस ने दिया था, कैरोलस लीनियस ने दिया था, देन आफ्टर द स्पीशीज नेम वी विल एड द थर्ड पार्ट. दिस इज कॉल्ड द साइंटिस्ट नेम. दिस इज कॉल्ड द साइंटिस्ट नेम. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. दिस इज कॉल्ड द साइंटिस्ट नेम. सो वी हैव टू एड इन द लास्ट. नाउ if anywhere you are looking, yeah, you are observing the three parts in the, for example, if three parts are present in scientific name, then it is called, three parts are present in scientific name, it is called trinomial nomenclature. Right? For example, first, second and third. अगर किसी पार्ट में आपको तीन पार्ट्स दिखाई देते हैं, किसी नेम में आपको थ्री पार्ट दिखाई देते हैं, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस फर्स्ट पार्ट इज कॉल्ड जीनस नेम, सेकेंड पार्ट इज कॉल्ड स्पीशीज नेम एंड थर्ड पार्ट इज कॉल्ड वेराइटी नेम. एंड थर्ड पार्ट इज कॉल्ड द वेराइटी नेम. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द ट्राइनोमियल नोमेनक्लेचर. बिकॉज इन द नेक्स्ट कमिंग वीडियो आई विल गिव यू द मोर एग्जाम्पल्स. I just am telling you only the summary. If in any scientific name you are looking, you are observing, you are feeling that there are the three parts in that name, except the name is scientific, scientist name who has given that name, that part, this part which is added we have in the last of the binomial nomenclature, this is not considered as the trinomial nomenclature, this is the binomial nomenclature, but except these, if after that we have to add the scientist name, so we will write in the last, for example in the Linnaeus. So this is considered as the trinomial nomenclature. This is considered as the trinomial nomenclature. So now come on the next topic, that is the rules for nomenclature. Right? So what are the rules for the nomenclature? The first rule is is genus should be written with capital letter and second name should be written with small letter this is the first rule. Second rule, scientific name should be in italic form and in handwriting should be underlined separately. Should be underlined separately as I have given here. And who are given these rules? These rules are given by ICBN, ICZN, etc. There are the many organizations which controls the different study of the different plants and animals or organism, that is called the taxonomy. Not only taxonomy, it is these are the organizations which study about the environment. So these are the organization, International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, International Code of Zoological Nomenclature, means this is the organization which provide the names to the plants. This is the organization which provides the names, scientific names to the animals. So these are the rules. Rules may be many more, but I have given the very specific rules which are important. So what are the rules? The first rule is, first name should be written with capital letter and second name should be written with the small letter. Mean species name will be always with small letter. If the variety name is given, third part is the variety name, then that also with the small letter. And second one is that we are writing with the hand. So it is not possible to write the italic form. Italic means tirche words karke likhna. When we are typing on the computer, then it is possible, but whenever we are writing with the hand, so it is not possible. So for that, what we have to do, we have to make the separate underlining of species name and the genus or genera name. Now third one is the genus or genera may be one for different species. Genera may be one for different species. For due to removing the confusions in the different species of the plants and animals, they have categorized the different species which are very closely related in the same group. For example, as I told you, for example, genus Panthera. This Panthera is used for lion, leopard, and tiger. Right? Panthera is the genus name, but these are the different species. Species are, as I told you in the last video, Leo, Pardus, Tigris. So what are these? These are the genus. Genus is Panthera for lion, leopard, tiger. Genus name is same for the three species, but there are the species are different for different kind of the animals. So for removing the confusions in writing the scientific names, he has concluded that one genera we can use for the more than one species, so that the removal of the confusions in writing the scientific name is very easy and possible. So my dear student, for the today it is the topic. I hope this topic is clear to you, and for more explanation, please have the proper practice with the given PDF files and make the proper notes, and so have the proper practice. All the best. God bless you.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.